Hello everyone, I'm back with a new topic, future trends in the accommodation industry. Over here we're going to discuss about the various new trends and the upcoming future of the hotel industry, the upcoming changes, the upcoming services, the category of various kind of accommodation over here, and the services which will be provided to us in the near future. For example, a category is known as the time share. Now there are many multinational companies are opening their hotels in different places, but the number of regular tourists is still the same. In such cases, the hotels are developing new trends to attract the new guests and new segments of the tourist. In order to keep this trend, there are certain new things which has been added to the hotel industry. Some are as a timeshare. Now, a timeshare is basically defined as to take a holiday on a brief period in each year, where the guest is offered an opportunity to purchase a fully furnished vacation accommodation and can travel on a weekly interval, on a weekly basis, and for that purpose they need not to have the whole ownership cost. And the amount which is being given to the company is for the maintenance and the for future purchases of that particular sector, which is being shared by a number of other purchases as well during that course of time. There are certain advantages of these kind of timeshares. That means there are certain positive points about the timeshare investments in the hotel industry. For example, the guest or the members who are indulging these kind of timeshares gets an opportunity to visit the different places and resides in a place of his choice. For example, of timeshare can be the Club Mahindra. Now, in this instance, the Club Mahindra has their various outlets or the various accommodation facilities. They have been into consideration with various number of hotel properties around the globe, and they works on the category of the timeshare where the customer or the member of that particular company have n number of properties on the basis of which they can choose by their own and can visit different places and can reside in a place of their choice. The owner of the property can arrange for a variety of entertainment programs for the stay. In a timeshare property, they can also cook their own food and familiarize themselves with their neighbors. These are the facilities that one does not get to experience in a hotel. Now we come over to a category known as the heritage hotels. These hotels are basically the old forts, palaces, the hunting lodges, which has been now been converted in the hotel category of the accommodation procedures. These are known as heritage hotel because these are built prior to 1950. The architectural features and the general construction should have the distinctive qualities and ambience which is keeping with the traditional architectural styles. For example, there are many of the places in India, majorly in the Rajasthan area, where you can get the heritage hotels. For example, HRH group of hotels are one of the best example of the heritage hotel category. There are various other categories which lies under the heritage hotel properties. The first is the heritage. The palaces, forts, the hunting lodges, resides built prior to the 1950 are comes under the heritage category. These kind of hotels should have a minimum of 5 rooms and 10 beds. The other thing is the heritage classic hotel, the palaces, forts, hunting lodges, resides built prior to 1935. This type of hotel should have minimum 15 rooms and 30 beds. The Heritage Grand are the palaces or the old properties which has been built in previous to 1920 that should have minimum 15 rooms and 30 beds. If you talk about the rooms and the bath sizes of these category of heritage hotels, there are number of rooms and the bathroom sizes prescribed for any of the rooms categories. However, the general ambience, comfort, and the imaginative readapting should be considered while awarding sub-classification to the classic or the grand. The size of the rooms and the bath sizes or the bathroom sizes are predetermined, but they can be changed as per the size or the category given to the various rooms of the hotel. A heritage hotel can only be said as heritage if they have the following architecture, or they need to follow a certain pattern of architecture of heritageness and architectural distinctiveness. Heritage classic hotels should provide at least one of the following. For example, the sports facilities. All the public and private areas, including the room, should have a superior appearance and decor. If you talk about the others, then they should have the swimming pool, the health club, the lawn tennis, squash, riding, golf course, providing the ownership best with the concerned hotels. Thank you so much.